I don't usually make spoilage, but when I do, it's legendary. Have you unlocked legendary quality using Aquila Science? If you're like me, you'll be itching for legendary mech armor and other related legendary achievements. This video is for you. For example, don't make legendary iron plates this way, do it this way. Producing one legendary iron plate this way will require an average of 2,700 common iron plates. It is also incredibly slow. Building iron chests, however, before recycling, averages one legendary iron plate every 300 common ones. Much better. So what makes the design on the right so much more efficient? First, let's talk about how quality and recycling works. When you put quality modules in a machine, you have a chance of getting an item of higher quality. The chance depends on the quality boost of the quality modules you're using. There are 5 quality levels ranging from common to legendary. When a factory gives an improved quality, it will usually be 1 level higher. But 1 in 10 of those items will get a second level of quality, and 1 in 10 of those will get a third level, and so on until you hit legendary. You might get lucky with a legendary item quickly, but you should expect to run items through factories many times to get to legendary. This is where recyclers come in. When you build the item you want, but it isn't legendary, you can recycle it to break it back down into ingredients. Since you can put quality modules into recyclers, this step can also improve quality. But recyclers only return 25% of the ingredients used to make the item using the default recipe. This loss is expensive, so minimize the number of times you have to recycle. The design on the left just recycles, which gives a good quality boost, but also a bad material loss. It's a good plus a bad, which will get you there, but slowly and expensively. The design on the right first builds a chest for an extra good quality boost. Then it recycles for another good quality boost and a bad material loss. It's 2 goods plus 1 bad, which is just much better than 1 good plus 1 bad. Basically, avoid using a recycling recipe that gives back the same item at 25%. It's better to build something first before recycling to get the 2 good plus 1 bad ratio. But wait, there is a more epic way to do this. If you have a factory that is building other stuff, and who doesn't? You can put quality modules in those iron foundries you should be using by now to produce a constant stream of mixed quality iron plates. The common iron plates get used as normal, and the mixed quality ones can be upcycled. Using the simple direct recycling approach, you will now get one legendary iron plate for every 200 mixed quality plates coming from your factory. This is even more efficient than upcycling through chests starting with common plates. And if you do upcycle these mixed quality plates by building and recycling chests, you will now get a legendary iron plate for every 60 mixed quality plates coming from your factory. That's pretty awesome. So why are we using iron chests here? Does this work just as well with something like iron gears? Yes, it does. But making iron gears only consumes 2 iron every half second. Iron chests consume 8 iron every half second. Iron chests work 4 times faster. Now, for the legendary way to do it. You can upcycle your iron plates by building and recycling green ships. You will need quality copper wire to match the iron, but as we'll see later, copper won't be an issue. Build the green ships using the electromagnetic plant. It has 5 module slots instead of 4 for a higher quality boost, and a 50% production boost. These boosts add up, and you will get a legendary iron plate for every 25 mixed quality plates used. Legendary! Of course, you might keep the legendary green ships you get instead of recycling them for iron. You'll get less iron plates that way, but you'll get a lot of legendary green ships. If you convert all the iron into green ships, you'll actually get 1 legendary green ship per 7 iron plates used. Wow, you will be producing a lot of legendary green ships. This approach does risk producing spaghetti. I built this design that makes green ships when supplies build up, chests if we have too many plates, and recycles copper cable if we have too many of those. The more your designs depend upon multiple ingredients, the more complex they're going to get. There are a lot of good choices for building legendary iron. If you prefer to do something simple and burn lots of resources, then have fun. After all, iron is infinite on Novice. And in space. And on Gleba, Fulgore, and Volcanus. You don't have to conserve it all. It's okay to burn a bunch. You just want to try and get to Legendary so you can start having fun. For Legendary Copper Plate, make and recycle copper cable in the electromagnetic plant. Just like recycling iron plates using green chips, you will get one Legendary Copper Plate for every 25 mixed quality copper plates used. One Legendary Copper Plate per 25 mixed qualities coming from your factory? That's awesome, right? Well, at first it is, but even Scrooge McDuck will eventually tire of the Legendary Copper and recycle it away. When I first realized I was drowning in Legendary Copper cable, it took me a while, but at some point you have no choice. After unlocking Legendary Quality, I wanted to build Legendary Quality 3 modules. So I put quality modules in my core factory to get some quality iron, copper, green, red, blue chips, plastic, and so on. Then I built this nutty quality factory one step at a time. Of course, it started with poor quality modules in the machines, but eventually everything maxed out and the factory stopped making quality modules once I had 200 stockpiled. Now it keeps running and makes legendary stuff I can use for whatever I want. Like legendary medium electric poles. Who needs substations? These things are awesome. And who doesn't want legendary exoskeletons? And oh, legendary personal lasers are seriously OP. This is especially true if you don't have behemoth biters yet. Maybe I should be polluting more? Meanwhile, I'm going to kill some bugs, man. This is really fun. Did you realize that legendary cargo bays add 50 cargo slots to your space station? You can use these to upgrade your early game ships without having to rebuild the whole thing. Anyway, back to my build. I was curious how well this works, so I wrote some Python code to simulate making legendary quality 3 modules from the excess quality goods my factory produces. Keep in mind that my base isn't big. I've burned through the starter patches the game gave me, but still have plenty of ores in the first real patches I've hit. This ain't no mega base. I looked at the past 10 hours of common item production. Then I computed how many quality goods I would have per minute if my factory had legendary quality module 2s in them, while still producing the same number of common items. I could put legendary quality 3s in them for an extra 25% return, but by the time I had enough of those, I stopped caring. The code tells me that this factory averages one legendary quality module 3 per minute. While doing that, it also produces 300 legendary copper wire, 70 legendary copper plate, 9 legendary steel, 6 legendary plastic, and 4 legendary LDSs. Bottom line, you don't need a mega base or a ton of time to make legendary gear. It did take me a couple evenings to build this since I started with poor quality modules and this factory uses nearly 400 legendary quality 3 modules, which took a while to build. Here's some quick highlights. Building and recycling blue chips is a great way to upcycle green and red chips because there is a technology for blue chip production. If a 50% productivity boost is good, 50% plus a bonus is even better. The Python code tells me I need 8 electromagnetic factories dedicated to making uncommon copper wire just to get through all the uncommon copper plates I have left over. That got completely out of hand, and I was already buried in copper, so I removed the quality modules from my copper and wire factories. I still have 6 of these electromagnetic factories, but 5 is probably enough. Wait, what, you ask? My main factory isn't producing any quality copper? Isn't that a problem? Well, no, because plastic gives me quality copper. The other factory I need 8 of is foundries for uncommon LDSs. I built those to upcycle the plastic I need to build higher tier red ships. The most efficient way to upcycle plastic is through LDSs because you can use the foundry recipe, that gives you a 50% productivity boost, plus the low density structure productivity research should be giving you an extra 30% or more by now. And here's the kicker. Recycling these gives me upcycled plastic, but also copper and steel plates. Sure, I have to use molten copper and iron for the recipe, but the LDS quality is entirely determined by the plastic, since it is the only non-liquid ingredient. This means that building and recycling high-quality LDSs only requires quality plastic. but gives back quality plastic, copper, and steel. So, yeah, I don't want quality copper byproducts from my main factory anymore. The last piece is superconductors. I need quality superconductors for Tier 3 quality modules. The best place to build them is on Fulgora, of course. I built them on Novus anyway to keep things simpler and just ship the holmium ore and plates from Fulgora. The awkward part of superconductors is that you can't recycle them back into parts. Instead, they just recycle back to superconductors, which sucks. So I upcycle them by building Tesla guns. Tesla guns need plastic, which is easy, but they also require holmium plates. Building and recycling Tesla guns gives me two chances to upgrade the quality each time I recycle. When I recycle them, they give me quality superconductors and also the quality holmium plates I will need to make more Tesla guns at the next level. There is a catch to this process I didn't realize at first. If your superconductor factory builds with quality modules, you will get next level superconductors, but you won't have the holmium ore you need to build a Tesla gun at the next level. This is okay if you use that superconductor to build a Tier 3 quality module, but I don't build Tier 3 quality modules at uncommon quality. So now I have a huge pile of uncommon superconductors I can't really use. So I switched my common conductor factory to use production modules instead of quality, and that fixes it. Oops. Having extra superconductors at epic and legendary quality is useful. They're good for Tier 3 quality modules and other things like supercapacitors and mech armor. Wahaha. Anyway, that's it. Build a factory like this and you'll be rolling in legendary quality 3 modules before you know it. And then you'll realize how useful legendary assemblers are. They go 2.5 times the speed of a normal assembler, and you can still add speed modules on top of that. The same thing is true for chemical plants. Can't build fuel for your space station fast enough? Replace the crushers and chemical plants with legendary ones, and you will instantly produce 2.5 times as much fuel without any additional power consumption. Great for upgrading your early ships. You will then want legendary electric furnaces to make ammunition faster, but these take stone bricks. To make legendary stone bricks, I first used concrete. After all, I could build it with a foundry for the 50% productivity boost, and recycling would also get back quality iron ore, which would be awesome for, like, making quality iron. The problem is that while concrete builds 10 at a time, it recycles 1 at a time, with the speed matching the time it takes to build 10. So recycling is epically slow for concrete. Recyclers with 4 quality modules have a crafting speed of 0.4. The foundry to make the concrete has a crafting speed of 3.2. So it takes about 3 seconds to make 10 concrete, but 5 times as long to recycle it all. So I gave up on the 50% productivity boost and started building and recycling walls instead. It's a bit less efficient, but meh, I've got another stone patch I can use. Eventually, I built legendary recyclers that are fast enough to keep up with concrete recycling, and I switched back to concrete. You'll also want legendary carbon fiber for rocket turrets and for legendary tool belts for your legendary mech armor. Best way to upcycle those is by building and recycling tool belts. Need spoilage for Tier 3 efficiency modules? Build and recycle nutrients. Easy peasy. Tungsten carbide for Tier 3 speed modules? That's a tough one. It's probably best to upcycle by building Tier 3 speed modules directly, since you can build those with electromagnetic plants and you get the 5 module slots and 50% productivity boost. Also, upcycling by building the thing you actually want is extra efficient, in this case yielding a legendary speed 3 module for every 30 common tungsten carbide invested. 30 common tungsten carbide per legendary module? That is awesome! But it will take 25 minutes to build each one if you only have a single electromagnetic plant for the common version. So you'll need a line of those to build them in bulk, and you'll burn through a lot of chips supporting this. Oh well, I don't see better options here. Biter eggs for Tier 3 productivity modules? Yeah, the same argument mostly applies. Best to upcycle by building Tier 3 productivity modules. You'll, again, need a lot of electromagnetic plants. You'll also want a bunch of lasers for eggs that spoil. The last real interesting items are quantum processors and tungsten plate. You need them together for railguns and fusion reactors. You could upcycle quantum processors directly, but this is probably a mistake since you can't use them unless you also have tungsten plate. So I'm going to destroy this mistake and build legendary real turrets by upcycling them directly. Cryogenic plants don't give you a production boost, but do have 8 module slots. I should get a legendary one for every 50 common ones I build. Not awesome, but doable. Now, go and make yourself a legendary factory.